Good morning, everyone, or depending on the time period, it may be good afternoon or good night. Okay, so today our topic is reinforcement learning. Myself, Dr. Debjyoti Bora, presenting you the lecture series on machine learning. So let's come to the topic without wasting any more time. First, we have to know that what is learning. Now, what is learning? Learning takes place as a result of interaction between an agent and the world. So how or why learning takes place? Because the agent, I hope you know what is agent. Agent is the one in artificial intelligence, we got this term agent, which actually, what happened, tries to collect information from the environment, tries to collect information from the surrounding, right? So that is agent. And based on those information, it performs some action. Okay. And based on the actions performance, efficiency of those actions, the agent, we call it as an ideal agent or a normal agent or an ideal agent. Ideal agent means is the one which is performing some actions, those are accurate, or we can say those are the ones that is actually matching those particular conditions, and those is actually optimizing the performance. Okay, that is an ideal agent. So that's enough for agent. That's an introduction of agent. If you want to know more, you will find my lecture series on artificial intelligence where I'm explaining about the agent in details, so you may check it. So here I just mentioned this term agent to let you know about learning. So learning is what? A kind of interaction taking place between agent and the world. And what is the idea behind it? Idea is that percepts, to remember, percept is nothing but you can consider them as input. Okay, input of information from the surrounding by that agent. So percepts received by an agent should be used not only for acting, but also for improving the agent's ability to behave optimally in the future to achieve the goal. So this means what? With those percepts, agents always tries to optimize its performance so that in near future, it will easily achieve the goal without any failure. So that is learning. The next thing that you have to know about learning is that the different types of learning. We have two main types of learning. One is supervised learning and another is unsupervised learning. Supervised learning and unsupervised learning. These things I also already discussed, but let me give you a brief introduction. Supervised learning means what? Where you have information about those data, right? Means you can think it as a kind of learning where one supervisor is there to supervise you throughout the learning process. So supervised learning is a situation in which sample, that is input output pairs of the function to be learned, can be perceived or are given. And unsupervised learning is just the opposite one. So there will be no such teacher or there will be no information about those what data or input or perceptions taken by the agent. Okay, you don't have any information of the data. So that is unsupervised learning. So unsupervised learning truly acts on those data where no information is provided. In case of supervised learning, we also call them as that level data or tag data, because we know about those data beforehand. Now, what is reinforcement learning? Our today's topic. So reinforcement learning, in this case, the agent acts on its environment. It receives some evaluation of its action. And that evaluation of its action is known as reinforcement, but is not told of what action is the correct one to achieve its goal. Have you got it? What this definition actually told to you? This means that this kind of reinforcement learning, what happens when agent acts on his environment? This is the agent, and say this is the agent, say this is the environment, right? So what happens when the agent acts on his environment about the performance of his action means what? Those actions will be evaluated, and based on that evaluation result, it will get it in terms of what? Reinforcement. Some rewards will be awarded to it, but it will not be told that which action, say two actions it perform, A1 and A2. It will not be told that which action will actually lead it to the goal. Got it? Don't be confused. I'm repeating it again. So reinforcement learning means what? When agent performs some operation on the environment, it will receive some evaluation of that action, and that we call it as a reinforcement. Right, that we call it as reinforcement. But which action will lead to the goal, that will not be informed. So it is based on that reinforcement, the evaluation of the action. So this is known as reinforcement learning. I hope now this definition is clear. Okay. Don't worry, I'll again give you one more definition, or it is the same. Right, that is, reinforcement learning is an area of machine learning concerned with how intelligent agents ought to take action in an environment in order to maximize the notion of cumulative reward. So again, you got two more technical terms, agent and intelligent agent. Guys, if you want to know more about this agent, I have a lecture series specially devoted to the artificial intelligence. You just search my playlist, you'll find my lecture series on artificial intelligence, and then you will find a lecture on agent, where I have discussed what is agent, what is ideal agent, what is intelligent ideal agent, like that. Okay, intelligent agents mean that those agents which are able to decide actually this, which actions are actually improving the efficiency, or whose actual action will means optimizing the performance, right? Those are the intelligence agents. So in the case of reinforcement learning, what happens, it ought to take those actions that will maximize the notion of cumulative reward, because every time it is performing some actions, it is getting what? The evaluation value, that is reinforcement. So reward. So it always tries to perform those actions only which will maximize the notion of those cumulative reward. Right, that is reinforcement learning. So reinforcement learning is one of the three basic machine learning paradigms alongside supervised learning and unsupervised learning that we have just discussed. So guys, now look at this figure. So in this figure, you will see what? This is environment. From this environment, this is interpreter. Okay. So it is this is the agent, right? This is the agent, right? From this environment, it is actually gaining some input. Now, what happened? Based on that input, it will perform some action on that environment, and those actions will be evaluated. And based on that, what happens? Some reward will be given to it. So this evaluation will be known as what? Our reinforcement. Okay, so it always tries to optimize its performance by performing only those actions which will maximize this reward. That's it. That is the reinforcement learning. Right? I hope now this picture is very much clear to you. So reinforcement learning tasks learn how to behave successfully to achieve a goal while interacting with an external environment. So guys, when you notice this figure, you will see that this SN always try to learn from his experiment, isn't it? Yes or no? Because see, what happened means when it performs suppose action one and action two, it gets good reward for action one, then it will always tries to perform that action with respect to that particular condition. Okay, say second for condition one, two actions are there, action one and action two, but action one got getting good reward. So it will learn that in near future also, one with respect to the condition, same conditions you want, then it has to actually perform action one, not action two. So what actually matters is here is what? Experience. Right? Experience is the one which matters in case of reinforcement learning. Right? So we can say that reinforcement learning is learn how to behave successfully to achieve a goal while interacting with an external environment. So learn via experience. And we can cite some examples like game playing. Players knows whether it win or lose, but not how to move at each step. Control. See, a traffic system can measure the delay of cars, but not know how to decrease it. These are the very good example of reinforcement learning. Let me ask you a simple question. The question one for this lecture is that, tell me one game which truly acts on the basis of reinforcement learning. I want to know the name of that game. You will just try it as a homework. You will comment the answer of that name. Right? That's interesting, no doubt. So one more picture for you to better understand the concept. So this is the percept, right? From the environment. This is our agent. State, okay, action, then evaluation of those action, accordingly some rewards will be given. So it is earning some experiences. So in near future, it always tries to improvise its performance on the basis of those experience. So that is reinforcement learning. Right. That's it. Now, let me clear this. So is intercept, this means what? Reinforcement learning model. Is intercept is, this small e means is percept, sorry. Percept, I already defined what is percept, that is information input. Is percept e is enough to determine the state? Okay. The state, we are talking about that as an state on the environment. Okay, so don't confuse. I again tell you that if you want to know more about this as an environment, types of environment states, so please search in my playlist, Artificial Intelligence. Okay, the agent can decompose the reward component from a percept. The agent task will be what? To find a optimal policy mapping states to actions that maximize long run measure of the reinforcement. Repeating it again, so what will be the agent task? To find a optimal policy so that mapping from state to action that will maximize long run measure of the reinforcement. That is our aim. Or you always try to optimize our long run measure of the reinforcement. So we can think of this reinforcement as a reward. That I already told you. So this RL model can be modeled as MDP model. So one question again comes to your mind that what is MDP model? So in this very class itself, let me tell you what is that MDP model. So MDP model is what? Markov decision process model. This Markov decision process model is a mathematical framework to describe an environment in reinforcement learning. So this MDP model is used, basically that is a mathematical framework to describe the environment in reinforcement learning. Okay. Now, next thing is that this, let's review this MDP model. But please, you can take a snapshot of this, screenshot of this diagram, of this figure. This is very important MDP model, either your exam point of view or interview point of view also. So MDP model, see, this is agent, state, reward, action, environment. From state S0, performing action 0, it comes to state S1, performing action, and for that getting reward R0. Again from S1, it comes to state S2, performing action A1, getting reward R1. Then from S2, it comes to action state ST, getting reward R2. So that overall picture actually tries to show through this diagram. Agent, state, for each state action, it is getting some reward. Okay, and everything we are performing on that environment. So S denotes state of stage, A denotes state of actions, and this TSAS, let me clear this, TSAS is equal to PSASA, the probability of transition from this state S to S given action A. Right, RSA, the expected reward for taking action A with respect to that state. See here R0, R1, R2. So similarly, you can define this one. RSA, we are taking the summation for all S. PSDES, SA, R, RA, SA, SDES. Right. So transition, with respect to transition, again summation for this stage SDES, TSA, SDES, R, ASA, SDES. So basically, this one, so from, so you can consider this diagram to better understand these two packs. So state from S0 to S1 with action A0 getting reward R0, S1 to S2 getting reward R1 with respect to action A1. Similarly for action A2, state S2 to ST getting reward R2. I hope this MDP model is now very much clear to you. So let me ask one question to you. That is the question number 2 of this lecture. What is MDP model and why do we need it in our reinforcement learning? So do comment your answer. Now, some more terminologies related to reinforcement learning that you have to know that might be asked some in some exams. That is, one is model-based reinforcement learning and model-free reinforcement learning approach. So model-based approach, these are two approaches actually, model-based and model-free. So model-based approach reinforcement learning means what? Learn the model and use it to derive the optimal policy. An example for is that adaptive dynamic learning process. Adaptive dynamic learning process. Then model-free is what? It will derive the optimal policy without learning the model. In first case, in model-based approach, you need to learn the model, but in case of model-free, you don't need to learn the model. You can directly derive the optimal policy. Example is LMS and temporal difference approach. I hope this is clear to you, right? So next question to you is that you tell me which one is better among model-based approach or model and model-free approach. So you just need to tell me through comment that which one among the model-based approach and model-free approach in case of reinforcement learning is better. This is the question number 3. Well, then, two more terms, that is passive learning versus active learning. Passive learning means the agent imply watches the world going by and tries to learn the utilities of being in various space. That is passive learning. And active learning means what? SM not simply watches but also acts. So in case of passive learning, SM is simply watching the world and tries to learn the utilities of being in various states. But okay, it is not acting actually. But in case of active learning, the agent just not just simply watching, but also acting. That is the difference between passive learning and active learning. Now, you tell me, this is the question number four. This is the next question actually. You tell me the advantages and drawbacks of passive learning and active learning is. Right. So that's all for today. I hope that this lecture on reinforcement learning is very much clear to you. And I hope this will help you to understand about this topic better. But still, if anything miss or if anything more you want to know, you can directly comment me. So guys, that's it. Thank you. We'll meet in the next lecture. Till then, Dr. Dibbo is signing out. Bye-bye. Take care.